A warm vibe. Welcome to Gladys Knight. She's got a book. I feel like Oprah. This is like the Oprah Book of the Month Club.
I know. Good. That's right. See, it's time that we tell our own stories. Yeah. Don't you think, Della?
I think so.
You know, for so long, we've allowed other people to tell our stories.
So long, we couldn't tell it because we wanted the job, you see.
Right.
And we had to kind of just like hold it in. Well, I already got a job now. I can say whatever I want to say.
Is it, you weren't shy in your book at all?
No, it was tough though, because I'm kind of, I've always been kind of private.
Uh-huh. Very private.
Yeah, but I just felt with all of the letters, you've always dictated my life. I mean, other than Heavenly Father, you've always dictated my life, what I need to do, what I'm going to do, whether my music is good, whether my music is not good.
I've never heard that before.
Yes, that's true.
Your music has always been good.
That's how
absolutely.
I've never heard of it. Bad notes.
But I got all these letters and fan mail and what have you, and they were saying, I want to be in the business. How do you do that? How do you mix family and being an entrepreneur or having a career? How do you be a woman in the business? How do you do this? And I felt that you were speaking to me when you sent me those letters. And for a long time, I did not do this book. I started it about 12 years ago, and my publisher was not really in favor of my life story at that particular time. It was the era, the beginning era of the talk show, you know, and they needed more sensationalism and they needed more revelations, I guess, in that time. And all I could do is say, hey, it's okay to be respectable. It's okay to be respected. It's okay to love one another, is what my book I was saying would be about.
Right, right. And what I did learn is that there's a difference between the perception of what Gladys Knight is and the reality of what you're really going through.
Absolutely. We understand that as you see us and as you lift us up, you create your own images
as to
who we are.
Absolutely.
Sometimes they don't want to know certain things about us. And that's why it wasn't a deep, dark secret, but that's why I didn't bring my pain to you. It makes me happy to make you happy with my music or my life, you know? And when I wasn't doing something that was in conjunction with your image of me, you would let me know. It's like I used to smoke. And people used to say, you don't look right with that cigarette. I'm serious, you know?
Because they had a different Gladys.
Yes, they had a different Gladys. And when I got involved in my gambling, even though I wasn't hiding it, the casino is a very public thing, but when I talked about that, that seemed to be something that people couldn't relate to as far as being a part of my life or shortcoming in my life.
Well, I think they use artists to escape through.
Yes.
That's why I never did anything but sing when I was singing only.
Yes.
Because they don't come to hear my problems.
That's right.
They come to get away from their own.
Right.
And they don't want to hear what trouble I'm going through.
That's right.
They ask me sometimes, says, well, when did you change from singing to acting? Every time I sang, I was happier than the morning sun. I wasn't happier than no morning sun, no evening sun either.
Right.
But in order to make you believe it, I had to act like
I was.
I wasn't always that blue, but I was singing the blues. So I had to act like I was blue because I get the original. You get a carbon copy. If my copy isn't clear, yours isn't going to be clear either. And you leave not having the experience that you want to have.
That's right. And that's what we're about, is to help you to get there. What you want to feel, what you want to experience is what our music is about. I've had people come to me and say, your music saved my life. That's something really,
absolutely,
really profound.
Absolutely.
Your music saved my marriage. Your music helped me through my divorce. You know, so
I have people who come to me now and say that they married because of Don't You Know.
Yes.
Or they married because of And That Reminds Me.
Yes.
And that's a very precious thing, that something I sang made the two of you know that you should be together.
You should be together.
And that was made in 1957, And That Reminds Me. And they're still together in 97 because of that song.
That's interesting.
Yes. That's good.
That's very good.
Yes.
Now I want to talk to you about Motown.
Okay.
The beginning days when you first signed.
Yeah. It was a good time.
Yeah? Tell me about that first day when you found out you were going to sign with Motown.
I didn't want to.
You didn't want to sign with Motown?
I did not want to.
Why is that?
Okay, this is show and business. Even though I was very proud of the accomplishments that this young man that I knew as a writer was making with this gigantic company.
Barry Gordy.
Barry Gordy. And all of the wonderful things he was doing with these artists and bringing them up and bringing them out. This is show and business. And the Pips and I were always taught to be more than our last record. We took lessons from a generation before us that taught us how to perform. Thank you very much, Delarice. We were about being the best performers that we could be. Mm-hmm. And so when it was about going to Motown, I felt career-wise we would not get the attention that we needed to move to the next level career-wise. The Pip said, hey, we've taken care of that for ourselves, so we need now that national record exposure. Mm-hmm. And Motown, they felt, would do that for us. We were both right. We did not get the personal attention that we felt we needed, but we certainly did get that national record exposure coming in 1967 with I Heard It Through the Grapevine.
Uh-huh.
So
now I heard from your book that I read that you say Diana Ross, that was Diana Ross's house. She was the one getting most of the attention.
Well, a lot of them got it, but
yeah,
yes,
tell
but
the
yes,
truth. Yes, she was
yes,
the one
did.
Getting
it. Said it right here.
Yes. Yes. Well, a lot of, well, Smokey was the baby too. Mm-hmm. You know, he was the original. Let's give him his credit too. The Miracles were the first group to come out of Motown, and they were very close to Barry. But that attention that we're talking about, that honing and
mold,
that
right.
molding and stuff, is what most careers need.
Did you ever
Miss
envy
Cute
that
was
she
getting
got
it? Miss Cute.
That's what you call her.
Yes.
Did you ever envy that attention?
No, I didn't really, but I saw.
No, I didn't.
Well, see, let me say this.
I didn't.
Let me say this for your fans, because I'm one of them.
Thank you.
All of that attention, all that flash, all that everything that she got, and I'm glad to see her with it. God bless her with it. But whenever we, your fans, wanted to feel something, we bought Gladys Knight and the Pips.
We did.
We did. I'm telling you the truth.
We'll be right back with these ladies in a minute. We got more to talk about.
And even now I sit and wonder, I wonder why.
You're like 12 years old in that one too, huh?
Thank you. Thank you very much.
I'm gonna show you something that you might not know. Your friend right here wrote in her book.
Okay.
She says she's had a few major disappointments.
Yes.
You know what the one was?
What?
I have never sung with Gladys Knight. Quincy Jones has never arranged for me. She wrote that.
Oh, Dilla. Oh, Dilla. You know what? I have not spoken to anyone about this or what have you. I'm getting ready to do, well, I'm in the process right now of doing a gospel album. And I'm going to make this statement right now. I would love for you to do a song on my album.
I will
me.
Only do it if you will work on my CD, my gospel CD.
You got it.
You got a song. Okay. And you know what? I'm doing this little gangster rap thing, and I was wondering if you two...
Yeah.
No.
Clean it up.
We can ooh behind
you. Yeah. You can sit in the back row like this. Hey, yeah. Just get
ooh,
busy.
Yeah. Ooh.
Now, what do you guys think of the music today? What do you think of these newer ladies?
You know what? Progress is always something good. We just have to be careful what we sacrifice in the name of progress.
What do you mean by that?
Our morals.
Mm-hmm. The nature
quality.
Of the music. The quality of the music.
It's too high a price to pay in the end. I'm all in favor. There's some good rap. Don't get me wrong. There's some good
like
rap.
Who do you music. Listen to?
But rap is not music. You see,
okay.
Rap for me.
Somebody say, oh.
For me, yeah. Rap is not music. It's not melodic.
Mm-hmm.
It's and it's angry. Most of it that I've heard is angry.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a lover. I don't need so much anger. Mm-hmm. I need to say about those things that are loving.
Mm-hmm.
And I need lyrics that mean something to, in order for me to sing them.
Oh, no, there's some lovers out there of rap.
Well,
LL Cool J.
I admit I haven't been listening good because as soon as you start talking about violence, I cut it off. Whatever it is,
right?
I'm not
yeah. Well, that's a certain group of rappers
yeah,
that do
well,
talk
maybe
like
that's
that.
That's all I've heard.
Right. I'll get you guys some CDs.
I'm a little up on it.
Oh, you are.
Hey. You know, in actuality, rap is really not a new thing.
It's the troubadour.
It's not a new thing. I mean, there was rap and music long time ago. What was one, thou shalt never love another. Thou shalt never love another. What was that? Rap. You know?
Well, you know, the troubadour went from city to city and from town to town and exclaimed the news in song, and that was rap, too.
Yes.
The troubadour?
The troubadour.
Yes.
Before there were newspapers, there were troubadours, men who went from street to street and sang, the king is coming today and he will be here this evening at 5.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Throw a little scratch on that, I guess. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. It's just a matter of putting it all together in a different way.
Uh-huh.
And I listen to LL and yeah, Roundaway Girl. That was one of my favorite pieces. You know.
Okay.
Yeah. I like that. So.
I want to ask you guys two quick questions. Looking back at your life,
yes.
Are there any regrets?
Not for me.
Not for me either.
Not for
everything
me.
I went through, everything that happened to me, made me the wonderfulness I am today.
That's right. It's the challenges in our lives that teaches us our lessons.
Absolutely.
And without those things, we would not be able to become the wonderful people
that
we are.
That's
you
right.
Had to go through some things to get here, even
yeah.
though you,
still
and I'm proud
things.
Of you. I am. And we must uplift each other a little bit
Absolutely.
More than we have been doing. We must let each other know when we're doing positive things or when we're doing it the right way. I want to say that to you publicly, because we can say it privately. Oh, he's really doing good. I want to say it in front of all your audience and that you're doing a wonderful job.
Exactly.
And I'm proud of you. You know, his pants ain't hanging all down low. He looks good. You know, you're wonderful. You really are a handsome young man.
Thank you.
Brother, I'm so proud of you.
Thank you. I want you guys, since you've never sung together and you're going to do something on each other's albums,
mm-hmm.
I want you guys to come back here and do a little something.
Really?
Yeah.
He
invited us back.
I'm willing.
Okay.
All right. But stick around, okay?
Okay.
Yo, another great guy coming out in a minute.
Okay.
Bronson Pinchot will be here in a minute. Thank you for joining us. We'll be right back.